Welcome back to Blue Jay Bonsai, and in this episode, we'll be doing the initial styling of my Melita, also known as a parrot's beak. But before that, we'll do a quick update on the fall preparations for winter. You can see the beautiful fall colors on the logo larch. There are just a few colorful leaves left on the Cotoni aster. Juniper's got some fall colors on it as well. Some beautiful fall colors on the Japanese larch. And there is barely a leaf left on my new amber maple. And here's the dwarf burning bush that David from the club gave to James. In the bonsai growing bed, the fall colors have definitely arrived. All right, so I have my tree tent or tree shelter set up for the winter. One of the senior club members, Mike, has something similar. So I decided to steal his idea. And if the trees don't survive out here, then it just means I shouldn't be growing them here in Canada. So, got everybody in there, nicely healed. And once the snow comes, I'll definitely be piling it in for some extra insulation. A few days later, we got our first big snowfall of the year. So let's go out and check on the trees and see how they're doing. Well, everyone's looking toasty warm, including the latest additions, the rosemary and lavender. I hope they like the snow because I threw a bunch of it on top. It's supposed to be insulation. I'll have to trust the senior members that they know what they're doing. So now that we're back inside in the toasty warm, it's time for the very first pruning or styling of my Melina, also known as a parrot's beak. The amount of growth on this little guy is just amazing. It's hard to believe it was just a little over 6 weeks that I first got this. So as usual, I'm going to start with just pruning off everything that's excessively long so I can get a better view of what's actually going on in there. There's the first round of carnage. So now we're ready for a closer look. We can go in and make some real decisions. The main trunk is very straight, and it has a trident at the top, as you can see here. Then again, maybe the branch on the left is actually the main trunk, because it's actually thicker than the one we were just looking at. But it really has no taper between it and the trunk below. So my mind is made up, and I'm chopping it off. Ah, what have I done? This so-called cutting is nearly as big as the tree that's left behind. But what is left behind is a nice trident. So we need to decide which of the three are we going to keep to be the new leader. Eeny, meeny, miny. Hey Mo! And with that decision made, I think I prefer the movement to the left versus the straight up stick in the middle. So in retrospect, I probably could have stopped right here. But since I am planning on using clip and grove on this tree, something about the main trunk is just a bit too straight for me. So I tried to evaluate what are all my options, using the old paper bag trick. Except the paper bag in this case is my hand. So as per my original feeling, this straight upright trunk needs to go. So, with a few more snips of the excessive little leaves, we're going to be left with the final product. So with a little bit of cleanup on our pruning stubs, we have the end result for now. I sure hope this little thing back buds and continues to grow for some future options. My little propagation jar has a few cuttings from my Chinese elm, and as you can see, they're starting to root. So I'm going to try putting some of the Melina cuttings in as well. And just to hedge my bets, I'm also going to try with some of the woodier cuttings using some rooting hormone powder and putting them into some bonsai soil. Give it a nice squirt of water, get it all nice and moist. Okay, Jay, I think that's enough water. And I might as well make use of my heat mat. It's been sitting around since I grew some kumquats from seeds. And a recycled plastic container makes this little propagation greenhouse complete.
Hey, Max.